Hello people, this is Sonali, the melodramatic bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. I'm here today to share with you my bookish hot takes. A hot take is something of a controversial opinion, but it's more of an internet slang, I think. At least that's how I interpret it. Like when I hear the term hot take, I'm instantly like, oh, so this is going to be an unpopular one, a controversial one. Like, not many people agree with these particular opinions. So that's what it's all about. That's the gist, I think. I hope I've explained it right. So Google tells me that a hot take is a piece of commentary typically produced quickly in response to a recent event whose primary purpose is to attract attention. Like, I make videos to attract attention. That's a different matter altogether. But on BookTube, let's take it as more of an unpopular opinion, a controversial opinion. So that's that. I have quite a few of these bookish hot takes, okay? So before I start listing out these controversial, unpopular opinions, I just want to say that these are my opinions and it's not an affront to you or a commentary to you. Every person has their own likes and dislikes. So I respect that about your tastes, and I hope you will return the favor to me. So another thing before we get on with this video is that if you've been here before, if you've been with my channel for a while, then welcome back. If you're new to my channel, then welcome to the Melodramatic Bookworm family. I make book related videos on this channel and occasionally a few travel related and a few movie related videos as well. So if you like my content and you like the kind of videos that I make, then please do hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button so that you can stay updated as and when I post new videos. So the first bookish hot take, like I'm literally coming in hot on this one, and this is a very unpopular opinion because I have seen that not many people dislike this particular author's writing, and that author is Margaret Atwood. Like, she's an award-winning author. She has written such an important book like The Handmaid's Tale, and it just, her writing just doesn't work for me. It feels like it is stunted and it puts the onus of, you know, putting the entire story together, the plot line together, on the reader's shoulders. And I get very annoyed by that. That happened with me for The Blind Assassin, that happened with me for The Handmaid's Tale, but I did like The Testaments. Maybe that was because of the time it was written in, that so much time has passed and her writing has changed or something. But her older works, not my cup of coffee. Huh. Bookish hot take number two. I'm still going hot. And this one is that I do not like Peter Pan. I feel like it talks about a number of topics that are, you know, guiding children the wrong way. It's misogynistic. It tells children that it's okay to do the things that Peter Pan is doing, like disrespectful things. And there's a lot of things going on there that I just did not like. And I can safely say that it's one of my least favorite classics ever. I know this is like a super, super, super hot take, but yeah, there it is. Hot take number three. The Twilight series isn't as bad as people make it out to be. Anytime I hear someone go, "Ew, Twilight," you're like, what's your problem? And moreover, the Twilight series, the books aren't as bad as people make them out to be. Please don't get that on me. Even I was shamed about, I think it was about 10 years ago, 10 or 12 years ago, for liking Twilight. So there was this conversation going on, and it came up in that, during that conversation, that I liked Twilight, like I enjoyed it, enjoyed reading it. And that one person, they went like, Twilight is like, okay, it's not that great, it's not literature. And I was, at that point in time, I was so affected by what they said that I believed for a long time that I was wrong to like Twilight. Like, I did not come out of that for a long time, and now I'm like, I'm embracing the whole thing, okay? I like Twilight. What are you going to do about it? Number four, this is something that has happened to me, and I have seen people do this when I sell books that I don't want anymore. They look down their noses at people who are selling their books. Like, why aren't you not giving them for charity? Come on, we need the money too. Like, I'm not saying giving to charity is not the good thing or even a right thing. That's the whole point. It is a right thing, not the right thing to do. It's just that there are needs and necessities also, so you cannot judge a particular person for doing that. And then as a subcategory to this very hot take, I'll also talk about all those people who expect, like, if they're buying two books, they'll be like, okay, can you give this book to me for like 30 rupees extra or 50 rupees extra when I'm pricing that at like 100 or 150. Hot take number 5, and this is something that I've already addressed before. I've made a video about it, and that is reader shaming. Reader shaming has got to stop. That's what I spoke about in my video. I'll leave the link here as well as in the description box below. But people have got to stop shaming other readers for reading what they do. If it's giving them joy, who are you or who are we as a whole, as a bunch of people, to judge them for what they are reading? If I come and say that I do not like your favorite book and I diss you for liking that particular book, then would you be silent about it? No, right? You would pick an argument. So why would you do that to other people? You would feel bad. So why would you do that to other people? Why would you make someone else feel bad for their reading choices? I mean, I can go off on a whole new video, whole new tangent about this, but let's stop it at that. Just reader shaming needs to stop. It's not a hot take per se, but more people need to understand this. More people need to accept that it's wrong. Hot take number 6 is, do not shame non-readers for not reading. Please, you can't go and say things to them like, you don't read, maybe you haven't found the right book yet. Come on, they don't like reading. Leave them be, leave them in peace. They just don't like reading. It's fine. Like, even I have been guilty of, you know, gifting a non-reader books, and then when I asked them about whether they had read the book, they were like, no, I don't like reading. And I went and said, I gave you a gift, you won't even read gift kya. I just shouldn't have gifted a book to a non-reader. And I've learned my lesson since then, and I have stopped doing that to non-readers. So basically the thing for all these is that you need to put yourself in the other person's shoes and imagine what you would feel like if they came to you with something you didn't like and said, you just haven't, you know, done the right thing yet. Like, how would you feel? Think. Hot take number 7. Reading any form of books is reading. Like, you could read audiobooks. You could read ebooks, you could read hardcovers, paperback. Do what makes you happy. Do what is convenient to you. Any sort of reading is reading. See, if a person is going around saying things like, audiobooks aren't real reading, who is that person to judge you for that, for your preferences, for what you like to do? Audiobooks are like storytelling. You're still taking in a story. It's still reading. Audiobooks, ebooks, hardcover, paperback, anything, any kind of book. I might have missed a couple here, but any kind of books is a book. And if you read any one of them, you're still reading. Bookish hot take number 8. You are a reader irrespective of how much you read. Like, people come and say, you haven't read in a month, then how can you call yourself a reader? No. Just because they haven't had the time to read in a month does not make them a non-reader. And calling them a non-reader is not an insult. But if you feel bad that you are not reading, then please know that you need to take care of yourself first. And with time, you will be able to read everything that you want to read. You are still a reader. Don't let anybody tell you that just because you haven't read in a long time, or if you don't read this certain number of pages a day, that it makes you a non-reader. If you want to be a reader, you are a reader. Books will always be here for you. Hot take number 9. Like, we are on the last leg of this video, and this particular point is one that I have noticed that a lot of people have started doing. It's as if these people, you know, they turn their noses up at Goodreads goals. Like, I know Goodreads goals aren't the be all and end all of reading, but there are people who enjoy doing them. They you know, the Goodreads goal motivates them to read more and read what they want to read. Like, people who don't do the Goodreads goals, it's fine. You don't do it. We respect that. People who do it, respect if you don't want to do. But turning their noses up at Goodreads goals is something that is helping so many other people and saying that Goodreads is just not my thing. I mean, it puts a lot of pressure on my shoulder. It's fine if you talk about your own opinion of Goodreads goals, but so many people even generalize it, and that's something that I do not like. Don't do that. Okay, so bookish hot take number 10. People need to stop using book titles with the same word in it. Okay, for example, The Tattooist of Auschwitz, The Librarian of Auschwitz, The Boy Who Followed His Father into Auschwitz. Stop using Auschwitz as a hook, and it's really overdone. You could use a lot of other titles as well. It's you are capitalizing on the success of one previous book and using that for your own. It's not right, at least according to me, and that is my bookish hot take, my opinion. And then there's every book after The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo and its sequels, and these books that start with the girl who or the girl with. They're overdone, people. Stop using these phrases in the titles. It feels like a ripoff. So the 11th and last bookish hot take, plus something that I really feel should happen, because I feel really strongly about this. This is one hot take that I really feel passionately about. It's that books with small fonts have got to go. Please do not print books with such small fonts that they give me a migraine. Even if I read a couple of pages, it gives me such a pounding headache that I just put the book aside. Make it more accessible. The font needs to be bigger. Why would you make people squint at your book, get a headache while reading the story? The whole point of writing a story, of printing a story, is that people need to read more and enjoy literature. But if you are doing this and people have to see through a magnifying glass, what is the point? Please make books with bigger fonts. Smaller fonts, chuck them. I know that I'm going to have a lot more controversial, unpopular opinions in the future, and if that happens, I'll make a second video about it. But until then, those were my bookish hot takes, my unpopular, controversial opinions. Which of these do you agree with? Which of these do you disagree with? Which bookish hot takes do you have? What are your unpopular, controversial opinions? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. If you like this video, please like it and share it to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.